Ya Imam Rusli ya sanadi anta babullah mu'tamadi fa bi dunya ya wa akhirati ya Rasulullah.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending salutations, peace and blessings upon the best of creation, the jewel and crown of creation, the beloved of Allah Almighty, the coolness to our eyes, the purpose of our lives, the reviver of our hearts, the inspirer to our minds, the awakener of our souls, the most honored one, the most praised one, the most generous one, the most kind one, undoubtedly he is the most beautiful one. None other than Sayyiduna Muhammadur Rasulullah Sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi wa barak wa sallam. MashaAllah, on this beautiful Friday here at Al-Hikam Institute in Bradford, whenever the sun's out, for the last year or so we've generally spend our Jumu'ahs and Eid prayers outside in the car park. And in all honesty, it's actually a beautiful feeling to read your Salah out in the nature with the nice cool breeze, or to read your Salah in a situation and circumstance like this is not a privilege that we get often here in the United Kingdom. Weather generally doesn't tend to be on our sides. But funnily enough, I mean, I mentioned it on the first night of Taraweeh. I don't know if you guys have noticed this as well, but in the last few years, last fair few years, we found that Allah Almighty has given us good weather in the month of Ramadan. Whenever Ramadan comes, it's always nice and warm, nice and hot. And it's quite unfortunate sometimes when I think we didn't take the initiative earlier to utilize this space to read our Salah outside. And with the current pandemic and everything that's going on around the world with this virus, corona, the coronavirus, COVID, research has actually proven that corona is not as potent and as serious outside when the sun is out and in the open space than it is inside together without much ventilation. So I think we're following what science is saying. We're fulfilling sunnahs as well. And it's actually a privilege and nice to be here to read our Salah outside in congregation like this, as brothers, as a community, as a local community. Today is the 3rd of Ramadan Kareem. If I was to ask just a simple question, what's the significance of today's date in the month of Ramadan? Yeah, you guys can go towards this side here on the right hand side as well, up until where the brothers have stopped making the saf, and we can complete one saf as well. What's the significance of the 3rd of Ramadan Kareem? It's Ramadan, it's a Friday. The 3rd of Ramadan marks the passing of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's youngest daughter, Sayyida Tayyibah Tahirah Fatima Az-Zahra Al-Batul Salamullah Alayh. Sayyida Fatima passed away on the 3rd of Ramadan, around 6 months after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Prophet alayhi salatu was salam were in the last moments in this world, in the dunya, Sayyida Fatima was around them, and so were other members of the household, the prophetic household, Ahlul Bayt, the likes of Sayyiduna Ali, Sayyida Aisha, and others. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen Sayyida Fatima very upset. And at that time when Sayyida radiallahu anha was in this feeling, because she knew that her father sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, these were their last moments in the dunya. And the Prophet alayhi salatu was salam called Sayyida Fatima. And they whispered something into her ears. She was crying at first, and then she began to smile. Afterwards, the household asked Sayyida Fatima, "What did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell you?" And Sayyida Fatima radiallahu anha said that on the first occasion when my father informed me that he was about to leave the dunya, and naturally it would upset any daughter if they were to hear that the father was about to leave the dunya. And Sayyida Fatima is the daughter of the greatest man to ever set foot on this earth. There's no man like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. There's no creation, no human like Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And Sayyida Fatima said, "I cried." And then when they told me after that the first person in my family, from my family, who will pass away after me will be you. Meaning that this separation between father and daughter, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Sayyida Fatima, it's very short. It's not going to be long. And it's well documented that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam left this dunya in the month of Rabi'ul Awwal. And Ramadan is only a few months after Rabi'ul Awwal. And on the 3rd of Ramadan, ghaliban a Friday, Sayyida Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha left this dunya. And what is so important, what is so special about this great woman? One great virtue that she and merit that she has, that no one other than her mother has in the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is that she is from the leaders of the women of paradise. Sayyidatu Nisa'i Ahl al-Jannah. And how many leaders of the women of paradise are there? 4. Who are they? Sayyida Asiya. Who is Sayyida Asiya? She was the wife of Fir'aun, but she was a believer in Allah. She was the wife of Fir'aun, the biggest tyrant man has ever witnessed or seen. You know, a human devil personified. This man was a tyrant that very few after him have even reached that level of tyranny. Fir'aun, about whom Allah talks in the Quran extensively. The most spoken story in the Quran is the story of Sayyidina Musa. Time and time again, every other surah, Allah Almighty takes us back to Moses and the Jews. And how Allah Almighty spoke to them, told them, informed them, or commanded them, how they disobeyed Allah's commands, how they disrespected Sayyidina Musa, how Allah Almighty ordered Sayyidina Musa, "Your mission and job is to stand up against the tyranny of Fir'aun. You've got to raise your voice against this man." And that was the job of Sayyidina Musa. And Allah Almighty equipped Sayyidina Musa with miracles. Allah Almighty equipped Sayyidina Musa with so much. And we see that Fir'aun's wife, Asiya, she was a believer. She believed in Allah Almighty. She actually lived in the house of tyranny. She lived in the worst circumstances one could live in. This was a man who claimed to be God. He said, "Ana rabbukum al-a'la, I am the biggest Rabb here. There's no one bigger than me here. On my command, people live. On my command, people die." The Hebrew nation, or the Jewish nation, the Bani Israel, they were tested and, you know, so many times. Persecution against the Jewish nation by Fir'aun is accounted for in the Bible, in the Torah, inside the Quran extensively. We see that. We see that it's evident. Yet Allah Almighty, in the very same house of Fir'aun, as a young child, as a baby, not even a child, a baby, inside the pram, who lands outside the doorstep of Fir'aun? Sayyidina Musa. The same man who's going to bring him down, grew up in that house. And the woman who nurtured, who took care of this great man, the Nabi of Allah Almighty, Musa alayhi salam, was who? Sayyidah Asiya. And Sayyidah Asiya is one of the leaders of the women of paradise. Sayyidah Maryam, Inna Allah astafaki wa taharaki wa astafaki ala nisa'il alameen. We chose you, Mary, over all women. We purified you. We chose you. You're the chosen woman. The Virgin Mary, the mother of Jesus. Sayyidah Maryam alayhi salam wa radiyallahu anha. One of the greatest women to have ever set foot on this earth. And what's her greatness? No man ever touched her. What's her greatness? Her chastity and modesty. That's what makes women great, their chastity and modesty. A woman hidden away is more beautiful than a woman which is plastered all over a billboard. And in the world we live in, unfortunately, it's a world where there's a lot about feminism, women's rights, gender equality, equal rights. Men and women are equal. Men and women are equal. And this equality, men and women are equal before Allah Almighty. How a woman will be accounted for, a man will be accounted for. But Allah Almighty has given slight eases to the woman that he did not give to a man. She is exempt from prayer for a certain period within every month, within a time frame. There's certain exemptions Allah has created for a woman, and she doesn't have to make them up. The prayers she's missed during the menses period, she doesn't have to make those prayers up. This is a mercy from Allah Almighty. And we see that the day and age we live in, how women are glamorized and in essence abused by marketing, abused by what's happening out there. They're plastered all over billboards. It's like if you want to sell toothpaste, put a woman on and watch how toothpaste will sell. If you want to sell shampoo, they don't put my hair on there. They don't put your hair on there. If they want to sell shampoo, they put a woman's advert. And I don't say these remarks in any sexist way. But when we do not honor the woman, and when we talk about honoring the woman, when we do not honor the woman and give her the rights that Allah Almighty has ordered and commanded, then the world will find itself in the position it finds itself today. Sayyidah Maryam. And thereafter, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Sayyidah Khadijatul Kubra, Ummul Mu'mineen, the first wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one whom Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam married and had not married any woman in that time frame, during that time. The one who gave Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam 6 children. The one whom Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved more than any other woman. The one about whom Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam would cry in her remembrance. Sayyida Fatima Az-Zahra radiyallahu ta'ala anha's mother. Sayyida Khadijatul Kubra radiyallahu anha. And Sayyida Khadija's daughter, Sayyida Fatima, is the fourth woman that will be the leader of the women of paradise. And Sayyida Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, I mentioned that every woman would go through, they go through this natural cleansing process, the menses. What made Sayyida Fatima unique from any other woman in this ummah? The ulama have written that Sayyida Fatima never experienced what a normal woman would experience. She never went through this. This was a karama, a miracle of hers. Why? That is a time where a woman is purified, their bodies are cleansed. Sayyida Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha is the most purest woman. Allah Almighty created her so pure. Radiyallahu anha. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam loved her more than everyone. Sayyida Aisha one day asked, Ya Rasulullah, who do you love the most? I mean, you're asking the greatest man on this earth, who do you love the most? From all of the creation of Allah Almighty, who do you love the most? And Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, I love Fatima more than I love everyone. I love her more than everyone. I love my daughter. And then they said, Sayyida Aisha said, وَمِنَ الرِّجَالِ And from the men, who do you love the most? And the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, زَوْجُهَا I love her husband, Ali ibn Abi Talib, more than everyone. In another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was asked, who do you love the most from the men? And they said, I love Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And who do you love the most from the women? Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu anha. I love the daughter of Sayyidina Abu Bakr, the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Sayyida Aisha said, in the entire complex of the companions, nobody resembled the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than Sayyida Fatima. Nobody behaved like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Nobody looked like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than Sayyida Fatima did. And Sayyida Fatima, she married who? One of the greatest men after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Sayyiduna Ali bin Abi Talib. The great warrior, the great soldier of Islam. The man who men feared in the battlefield. The man about whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Aliyu minni wa ana min Ali. Ali is from me and I am from Ali. Man sabba aliyan faqad sabbani. He who curses Ali has cursed me. About whom the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, Man kuntu mawlahu fahadha aliyun mawla. Whoever I am his master and leader, Ali is his master and leader. About whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam said, Ana madinatul ilmi wa aliyun babuha. I am the city of knowledge. But the door to that city is Ali bin Abi Talib. Ana darul hikmati wa aliyun babuha. I am the house of wisdom. And the door to the house of wisdom is Sayyidina Ali bin Abi Talib. This great man married the greatest woman, Sayyida Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, the leader of the women of paradise. And about whom Nabi alayhi salatu salam would say, Fatima tu bad'atu minni. Fatima is a part of my body. Man adaha yu'zini. Yu'zini man adaha. Whoever harms her has harmed me. Whoever's angered Fatima has angered me. Whoever's upset Fatima has upset me. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam had immense love for Sayyida Fatima. Immense. And Sayyida Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, a woman who spent her entire nights in the worship of Allah and spent her days in fasting. Sayyida Fatima radiyallahu ta'ala anha, about her, it is said that she radiyallahu ta'ala anha on one occasion came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when she got married early, the early days of marriage. And she asked the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam for somebody to help with the house chores. There were difficulties, were hard, it was difficult. Sayyidina Ali wasn't the richest companion, he wasn't wealthy like Sayyidina Abu Bakr or Sayyidina Uthman. They were rich men. Allah Almighty blessed them with immense wealth and they were blessed with immense status and merit. Because they gave their wealth in the way of Allah. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Uthman, they were businessmen, wealthy businessmen. Whatever they touched turned to gold. Sayyidina Ali wasn't that wealthy businessman. Sayyidina Ali was that young man who was always spending time in the worship of Allah Almighty, who was busy with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he wasn't the wealthiest, he didn't have a huge bank balance, he didn't have gold and mountains and stacks of gold. Allah Almighty tested the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Ali radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, nevertheless, at that time, when Sayyida Fatima came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, you know, things are hard at home. It's difficult, my hands are tired, you know, preparing the wheat and preparing the food. I'm alone with Ali and The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, I'm going to give you something that if you read daily, the hardships and difficulties within your home will disappear. And you know what that is? That's something that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave to Sayyida Fatima, but in reality was giving to the Ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to me and you. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that when there's hardship within your home and you're doing your daily chores as a woman, 33 times read Subhanallah, 33 times read Alhamdulillah, and 34 times read Allahu Akbar. Do this and you'll see that your problems and the stresses within your home will go away. When we get stressed at home, we ring our sisters and we complain to them. I'm talking about our wives or our sisters. When we get stressed at home, we don't turn to Allah. They'll start bad mouthing the husbands, the children. They'll say, oh, there's a jinn in the house, there's possession, there's this problem, there's that problem. They'll want to fix their problems, but they'll be too focused on watching the drama on ZTV and where else. And how do you expect your problems to go away if you do not turn to Allah Almighty at the time of hardship, difficulty? And Sayyidah Fatima was given this, but in reality the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving us this. This was advice for me and you. This was advice for us. And just to understand, though Sayyida Fatima was the greatest from the Ummah of the Prophet ﷺ in terms of women, one of the greatest women. Of course, there's no doubt that the undisputed greatest after the Prophet ﷺ is Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. And one day we'll talk about his merits and virtues and greatness. But Sayyida Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, and I finish on this, and this is a warning for us. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said that if my daughter Fatima had stole, I would order that her hands would be chopped off. For the past 30 minutes, you've listened to the great status of Sayyida Fatima and how great she is and her merits. But look at the greatness of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They said that if my daughter Fatima had ever stolen, then I would cut her hands off. Now the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is making a huge statement here. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is telling us that nobody is exempt and above the Sharia. Not even my daughter, even though she's the greatest woman and she's one of the leaders of the women of paradise. Nobody exempt from the Islamic law. You are not above the law of Allah. If my daughter is wrong, then my daughter will receive the punishment for wrong. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is telling us that we are governed by the law of Allah Almighty. That even for one wrong that we do, whether that's wronging the rights of people, this is one of the common things we do, we wrong people's rights. I mean, I've just come back from Pakistan and the state of people there, they just chopping each other, cutting up each other, wronging people's right over land, over marriages, disputes. Disputes arise when you don't have Allah Almighty to govern over you. You don't choose the law of Allah Almighty over you when you allow your nafs to take over. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam is telling us categorically, and they're using their own daughter as an example, that if my daughter was to ever steal, then the punishment would be liable upon her. Meaning that nobody is above and exempt from the Sharia of Allah Almighty. We will all be held accountable one day, my brothers. And the last ever verse to be revealed in the Quran, the last verse ever to be revealed, was the verse in Surah Al-Baqarah where Allah Almighty says, prepare for that day where you will stand before your Lord and you will be accounted, held accountable. And there will be no injustice done to you when you're going to be held accountable. If you've wronged people, then make it right in this month of Ramadan. If you've done man's over, then go and apologize. Be the bigger man and fix your own akhirah. Make your akhirah right. It does not make you any lesser of a man If you was to go and apologize for wronging someone, that I wronged you, I took your right when I shouldn't have. And this is why we should turn to Allah. We should be holding ourselves accountable. And it's important that we keep this in mind. May Allah Jalla wa Ala allow our daughters, our mothers to follow in the footsteps of Sayyida Fatima radiallahu anha. May Allah Almighty allow us to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah Almighty forgive us for all our sins. Wa akulu qawli hadha. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Wa akhu da'waya anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Ya imam rusul ya sanadi anta babullahi mu'tamadi fa bi dunyaya wa akhirati
ya rasul Allah
khudh bi yadi.